favorite American candy?
Eggs made in the USA.
How about everyone and welcome back to my channel. Did you guys miss me? Don't answer that. I'm Adiola and welcome. So today's video is going to be another American Eats British Candy video because I got such an overwhelming response of suggestions and comments from the last one. I just got back from the UK, so when I was there, I hit up Tesco and tried to get as many as the suggestions that you guys gave me. So today I'm gonna be trying out all those suggestions. So if you wanna see that, stay tuned and you might as well subscribe because I'm gonna be bringing you guys a whole bunch of content. Thank you so much for all the love you guys have been showing me. Yeah, let's get started. Last time I started out with all the chocolates, so I guess this time I'll start with like the snacks and the crisps. So here we go. I got a lot of suggestions telling me to try out the flavors. So here we go. Oh my god. Okay. I like these. I like anything cheesy. Excuse me. I'm a fan. I could do these. They taste like they're really cheesy. They're very light and airy. These are good. Oven baked Walkers. And they're cheese and onion flavor. I like cheese and I like onions too, so it's right up my alley. They taste like regular like baked chips. I think Walkers and Lay's are owned by the same like family company, so this is nothing like crazy. Like this tastes like something that we have here. Not bad. I have another bag of Walkers, except for these are cheese and onion, but they're just like the regular ones. I like these more than the baked ones. Of course, you know, the baked ones are probably better for me, but I prefer these, for sure. You know you're getting old when you start looking up the ingredients in your junk food. That's when you know you're getting old. Another bag of Walkers. And these are the salt and vinegar flavor. I'm not a huge fan of vinegar chips in general, so that little kick at the end caught me off guard. I think I prefer the cheese and onion, to be honest. Oh, I'm really excited about trying these. Everyone kept telling me to try these. These are Hula Hoops. We don't have anything like this here, so I'm excited about this. Okay. First of all, this is barbecue flavor. Tastes like I'm eating beef Maggi Q. I don't know if you guys know what Maggi is, but it's like proper seasoning that most Nigerians use. We normally use the chicken. Like the texture. It's very crunchy. The flavor is a no for me. It's actually a hell no. Never again. That's it for the crisps. We're gonna try out the cookies. I'm actually really excited about trying these Jammy Dodgers. Apparently they're like a teed out there. I'm actually scared because I hate fruit filled stuff. It's a little too chalky for me. Fruit filling makes me feel uncomfortable. It's like still shortbread cookies. It's a no for me, dog. I'm not gonna be calling anybody's food trash this time because the way that you guys dragged me. Last time you dragged my soul for calling the food trash. So this is just, it's a no for me, dog, this time. So next I'm gonna be trying the Fox's Party Rings. They're actually like adorbs. It has like frosting on top, like of a cookie. I like the melted frosting on top. Like they have the, like different colored ones and stuff like that. And I like the colors are all like pastel. Oh, they even have a lavender one. I love lavender. Very, very sweet. Like I can feel the sugar backlash. Okay, next is Rice Krispie Squirt. What? We got these.
like Rice Krispie treats, okay? They're basically like Rice Krispie treats, but they just call them squares. It tastes like orange here. They're good. I'm gonna eat this whole thing right now. Is there food in my hair? The Rice Krispie treat in my hair. Lol. So now we're gonna move on to sweets. So, okay, so this is like called Candy Kittens. And it, apparently it's like gourmet sweets. This is the blueberry bliss flavor. Oh, these are bougie. They have like, they're vegan, they're gluten-free, natural colors and flavors, and made with fruit juice. Okay, that's my kind of thing. I like kind of organic sweets, or like not organic, but like health conscious sweets. And I wouldn't feel bad about eating these or giving these to children, because they're gluten-free. My best is Maynard Bassett's Jelly Babies. Jelly Babies. I already feel like I'm just gonna be annoyed. Okay, first of all, we're gonna discuss these jelly babies really quickly. Why is there a confession of sugar on the outside of this joint? It's sweets, and they now dip it into confectioner sugar. These are a no. I'm going to bin these, okay? I'm binning these. Next, we have flying saucers. I already know this is gonna be a problem. It feels like plastic. And so it's called flying saucers. They're made by Tesco, apparently. Apparently, it has no artificial flavors or colors. However, it feels like a toy, so I don't know how that works. Tell me how that works. All right.
It feels like styrofoam. Like, I'm legit scared to eat this.
There's like stuff in the middle. There's a lot going on here. It's like styrofoam on the outside. Then they now put sweet and sour powder in the middle. I like the substance in the middle. I think that's really, I mean, it's like eating a pixie stick or something. But why am I eating an egg cracker? Another Tesco candy. I don't know how I feel about these Tesco candies. And this one is called bubblegum flavor mushrooms. These people are not serious. Like, I'm legit scared to eat these. These feel like they're gonna taste like the Jelly Belly. I will not be a part of this. It's like mushrooms. Like, you guys were obviously doing shrooms when you sat around in your boardroom and were like, oh, let's make mushrooms that taste like bubblegum. Oh yeah, it's a no. I'm not here for the Tesco candies. This one's called Dolly Mixtures. Give it a try. I guess it's just a whole bunch of mixtures of candy, more like gummies and stuff like that. Can I just like Mike Nuts? I'm gonna try this one. I don't really like that flavor. I like these little, what shape is this? I don't know what shape this is. I'm gonna pass on all the Tesco related candies, okay? Back with the crunchies, okay? Like last time I ripped the crunchies to shreds. So my friend said I should try the crunchy rocks, but they're better than the bars. So I'm giving her the benefit of the doubt. She's right. The crunchy rocks are actually bomb. The crunchy bar was not it, but this is good. Oh, I like these. I'm happy. These are making sense. It's making sense. I'm excited about trying these. You guys suggested these. The Cadbury Oreo. I love Oreos, and I love Cadbury. So, I'm about to get all popping. Sorry, I'm gonna be bush. I'm a bush girl. Ooh, it has Oreo filling in the middle. How pretty. Bomb.com.org.
www.ohio.gov.
Hell yeah.
I even love the packaging, like just so clean and crisp.
I love this boots.
A couple of people asked me about the arrows too, so I'm gonna try the arrow purely chocolate. Oh wait, feel the bubbles melt. It's just chocolate, but it's just like bubbles in the middle. What gives it an extra layer of texture or whatever. And the chocolate's good. It's good. I don't think I would just go out of my way to get them again though. I saw these Kit Kats and we don't have these in America. The first one is the Ruby Cocoa Beans. And they're like pink. And I just thought they were so cute, so I wanted to try them. Disregard how the chocolate looks because it's all melted. It's been literally sitting in my bag for like a week now. Here, I had to read the package because I didn't know what was going on. Okay. At first, I thought I was eating white chocolate. Then I now start to experience some fruitiness to it. And apparently, this is Ruby Cocoa Beans. A new delicious and unique berry flavor experience. So essentially, I'm eating what seems like white chocolate, strawberry white chocolate. Okay. But it's good. It's just different. I don't know. I don't know if I could personally do it on a regular. I also saw these Kit Kats. It's called the Chunky New York Cheesecake Kit Kat. This could be either really bad or really good. Here it goes, that way. That's cheesecake layer on the top, and then it has like just the regular Kit Kat waffle. What do you call those? Waffle? Wafers. These are really good. Munchies. They're called munchies. They're made by Nestle again. I'll try it out. There's caramel in the middle. It was like a little chocolate square with caramel in the middle. They're pretty good. This is called a Milky Bar. And here we go. Ooh, I like this. 10 out of 10. It's just regular white chocolate, but it's good. Like, I like their chocolate. These are called Mikado. It looks like it's like pretzel covered chocolate. Like pretzel and chocolate, so you got some crunchy, a little bit of savory and sweet. I like these called toffee crisps. If you watched my last video, you already know how I feel about toffee. Five out of ten. Can't be bothered. I really can't be bothered. This one's called Smarties. Okay, it looks like M&M's. It actually tastes better than M&M's because the chocolate inside tastes better than like the chocolate here. So, Smarties are pretty good. So, apparently this is like a very British snack. It's a chocolate orange. Oh, it's like little orange slices. How cute. Aren't you glad to see me?
Oh, yeah.
I like it. It reminds me of those orange creamsicles. Where it's like a chocolate version. Okay, so this one's called Caramac. It's like chocolate, but it's like caramel flavored chocolate. So it tastes like caramel, but it's actually chocolate. I guess British people have a thing for flavored chocolate. It's not bad, it's really good. I would give it a 6 out of 10. Okay, you guys, that is it for the video. Thank you guys so much for tuning in, and if you're not already subscribed to my channel, be sure to do that. Let me know what your favorite snacks are, what your reactions were to my reactions, and just any questions or anything you would like to say to me. I'm always commenting, and I try to reply you guys as soon as possible. And I just want to thank you guys so much. I love you guys. Until next time, see you later.